And welcome back. We are in downtown Savannah. We are located over here on Oglethorpe and Abercorn Street, and you're seeing Drayton Street behind, and the parade has now made it to the reviewing stand as we are watching the people. Savannah Police Department were the first to make their way through. And then we also have Savannah's Police Chief, Roy Minter, right there, making his way, helping to lead this parade, snapping off a salute in front of the reviewing stand. Going up there and getting some handshakes as well. And we are also seeing some of the other officers. We saw the motorcycle police as they were driving by just seconds ago as well.
We're going to get to see a lot of the past veterans of the year, and they're interspersed throughout the parade this year. They're always members
hey,
of
Chief, how you doing?
Different organizations, so they kind of wear multiple hats.
to say the least. And even those that, as you mentioned, we're not only seeing past veterans of the year, they still are a part of the organizations. Just because they were, let's say, 10 years ago, they were veteran of the year, they still love being a part of this.
Yeah, and here we have Jim Grismer, otherwise known as The Grizz. Jim was he was in uniform in the New York National Guard during the Vietnam era. Was also a New York firefighter for 34 years. Just a wonderful guy. And he was a past commander of American Legion Post 135. He's a member of the 40 and 8. Has done so much in his long and storied
career. Hey, Jim, how are you doing? I know. true fact, they used to be neighbors with me as they moved down here into Savannah. So they live just a few doors down from me. And, of course, Jim, one of the volunteers at the Mighty 8th Air Force, helping out with that restoration of the B-17, the city of Savannah.
Yeah, just loves that thing.
And there we're seeing members of the Scottish American Military Society.
Led by Jim Vahar, who is also a past Veteran of the Year. So, retired colonel and just a proud Scottish American veteran.
To say the least, and of course carrying the American flag with them.
Yeah.
And thankfully a nice warm day for you guys, right? Jimmy, well, that's one of the things we do have to say. Jimmy Ray usually is up here helping us out with the parade, but he's a little under the weather right now, so.
So you're stuck with me, Jim.
So you get Mike Ball this year, but want to give our well wishes to Jimmy Ray out there, of course.
Definitely.
Jimmy Ray, he's the man, the myth, the legend around here. He knows everybody and everything.
Yes, he is. He is a member of 9 different veterans organizations in the Savannah area. And that is something we can only aspire to.
Right. And there we see Chief Jeff Hadley with the Chatham County Police Department.
And there we have O.C. Fowler, this year's Veteran of the Year.
And he's got a long list of accolades as well.
Very much so. Very much so. He's a Vietnam veteran, naval commander, was a member of the Navy Sea Wolves, the only attack helicopter squadron in Vietnam from the Navy.
Really?
So he's also just recently been inducted into the Georgia Military Hall of Fame. So we're pretty proud of him.
And that's with his military service. And around here, you might know him as, he's a big volunteer, joined up with the USO. And I know he's volunteered. Yeah, and supports and has supported so many of the deploying and redeploying military members and troops at Hunter Army Airfield. So, his service definitely wasn't done when he finished with the Navy.
No, and he was voted as the Veteran of the Year by a unanimous vote of the Veterans Council. So that was pretty unique.
And coming up, we also have part of the Navy League of Savannah, and as you mentioned, O.C. Fowler, highly
Remember
decorated
that?
Navy veteran of that. Yep. And as you said, mentioned just the USO that he's part of, but also with the Navy League of Savannah, being a big member of that as well.
The Navy League this year is headed up by Tom Nichols, another highly active veteran in the Savannah community.
There we go. Pat Jovich, region president, South Atlantic Coast for the Navy League of the United States. Happy Veterans Day. There.
And here we have Tom Nichols. He's the local chapter president, so. Very, very instrumental in the nomination of O.C. Fowler for this year's Veteran of the Year. So. And next up, we have the Vietnam Veterans of America. Their chapter is headed up by Joe Mitchler this year in their jungle greens.
It's amazing to see these veterans out and about taking part in this wonderful Veterans Day parade, and we do salute you for your service. And as you said, Vietnam Veterans of America, Chapter 671.
A proud and initially under-recognized group of veterans.
Obviously, yes, when they came back. And Savannah really is one of those areas, though, that makes sure that you do get the recognition.
Yep, definitely.
And Vietnam veterans, we salute you for your service. And you might see a few of these with a little larger contingency than normal because there was the chance of some rain out here earlier. Says I think they had the hard shell vehicles as well as being able to be out and about and wave to the crowd. And look at this. The 3rd ID, the 3rd Infantry Division, making their way up here on Oglethorpe Street.
And this year their contingent is led by Colonel Eric Vanek of the Aviation Brigade. And the band not far behind him.
Thank you. Amazing hearing the Third ID band perform. And we're going to be sticking with the Third ID. As the band will be playing in about a minute and a half, I believe. I actually believe we're going to be hearing Taps from the Bugler.
Yes.
Coming up the 11th day of the 11th month of the 11th hour.
Very apropos that we have the Third ID here, the Marne Division, named for the Battle of the Marne in World War I. This year also marks the 100th anniversary of the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier.
So back to 1921.
Yep.
Forward. March.
Thank you. And coming behind the band, we also have a contingent from the Third ID. A small contingent of soldiers. Representing the entire division.
Gives you chills each and every time you hear Taps played.
Yes,
like that.
Yes, it does. Very much so. But the Third ID this year, commanded by Major General Charles Costanza, and his Sergeant Major is Command Sergeant Major Quentin Fenderson.
And thank you to all of our Third ID and for everything they do and all of their service. We appreciate each and every one of you.
Yep.
Next. And checking out Take a Soldier Fishing. This is just a chance to help veterans kind of acclimate back into society, you know?
A bit of decompression there.
Exactly, and nothing better than just kicking back and fishing.
And they're followed by the Benedictine Military School, the cadets there.
It's 1902. The cadets, so proud. Proudly marching here, honoring that tradition that they have upheld so well here in Savannah.
Such a great preparation for these young men. even if they don't enter military service, you know?
And to have that bond amongst those, that once a cadet, always a cadet, it seems like here.
Yep. Next up, we got the
Catholic War Veterans.
Yeah, led by Billy Cope this year as their chapter president. So, great group
hey
of guys.
There. How you doing? Love seeing these old vehicles as well as they're pulling some of these floats.
It takes a lot to keep those things running, that's for sure.
Morning. And coming up behind the Catholic War Veterans float, we have the
Savannah Christian Academy
Prep School Band, the Raider Marching Band. Seeing some of the little ones out there waving the flag.
It's always great to see when you're able to walk in the parade and how many of the kids are just really tickled to get a U.S. flag.
Beaming with pride out there as they're watching as well.
Of course, they don't mind the candy that we give out either.
No, that doesn't hurt. Might hurt the parents later when the kids won't sleep, but. All right, let's take a listen again. This is the Savannah Christian Raider Marching Band. Very good. Savannah Christian Prep School Band, the Raider Marching Band.
Coming up next, we should have the illustrious mayor of Savannah, Mr. Van Johnson.
And the rest of City Council should be a long way as well. Checking to see if we got a lot of sunshine or if that's just a blur.
Maybe we need to focus.
As you said, that's a beautiful sight when you're seeing people waving the flag coming up when you're marching in the parade. And as you said, children watching their parents or possibly even grandparents takes on extra pride.
Yep. Yeah, when you've served and possibly volunteered to die for that flag, it means a lot. Coming up, we've got another former Veteran of the Year, Mr. Doug Andrews.
Looks like Doug. Yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah,
he's a character.
that's putting it mildly. But
Doug's a good man.
You know, very, very active in the veterans community, does a lot of work on their behalf, and was very instrumental in getting the World War II Memorial constructed downtown there on River Street.
And checking out one of the convertibles. We got a lot of sunshine now, which is good for the parade. It definitely has turned into parade weather out here. Might even be a little bit warm for the Veterans Day parade than what we're used to.
A little bit warmer than normal, yeah. Got a Richard Sanders, excuse me, the candidate for judge for the recorder's court.
There.
Nice day for a ride in a convertible Camaro.
What now? Well, Jimmy's a little under the weather right now. We do miss him, definitely. You know. You got some sunshine now. You got to get some sunscreen on you.
I told Jimmy Ray I'd be ready for the debrief when this is all over. So I just hope I can do him a little bit of justice.
Well, Jimmy's just a great guy. And Mike, we want to thank you for being out here today. You've done a fabulous job so far, and we can't thank you enough for being out here and filling
in. My pleasure. I do refer to Jimmy as Mr. Savannah, but
I would think that's apropos, that title.
And here we have the color guard from American Legion Post 184. They appear at multiple events throughout the year.
Still in fine step, too, as we heard.
Yes, they are.
And just to let you know, they're sometimes stopping here because we're in front of the reviewing stand, so these members and the floats and the bands of people, they stop here in front of the reviewing stand, and also right located with Abercorn as well as Oglethorpe, so they're making sure that intersection is clear right behind us as well.
Definitely.
So that could be with the slowdown here at point. So just want to make our viewers aware of that.
So we've got the rest of the vehicles from American Legion Post 184 out there
George
in Thunderbolt.
Ganem. Of course, George Ganem.
George Ganem was the first American to die in Pearl Harbor.
Yep, from Savannah.
Yep.
And there we're seeing part of Savannah City Council now walking in the parade. Happy birthday!
Yep, happy
Good
birthday.
Good to see you. Hey, Mr. Mayor. Good morning. How are you doing?
Good morning, Mr. Mayor.
Hey, Estella. How are you? Then we see the Garden City Fire and Rescue Squad.
Always nice to see the first responders out. See them represented.
As well as the Garden City Police Department. All right, part of the U.S. Marine Corps Junior ROTC, we have the Whale Branch Early College High School Warriors. As well as their high school band that will be coming in front of the reviewing stand.
Pretty sharp looking youngsters.
That's Whale Branch High School Band and members of the U.S. Marine Corps Junior ROTC. There's Whale Branch in Beaufort County.
And coming up, we have the Chatham County Sheriff's Department.
Led by the Chatham County Sheriff Color Guard.
And closely trailed by our sheriff, John Wilcher, also a veteran himself, member of American Legion Post 135. We're honored to count him among our Confederates.
And the sheriff, he does enjoy these parades.
Yes, he does. He enjoys serving the community, that's for sure.
There we have Chester Ellis, chairman of the Chatham County Commission. We got Gator Rivers, Commissioner District 2, but many of you might know him as well as a Harlem Globetrotter. Now he's just showing off.
Oh, yeah. Doing what comes natural.
Eddie Milton, hey there.
And
Aaron Whitley, yeah, Commissioner of District 6.
Yep. And coming up, Savannah Fire and Rescue. I think you can hear them.
Yep, you see the big old ladder trucks as well. And you're going to be hearing the sirens.
One outfit that's hard to miss.
Always amazed at how high those ladder trucks go.
Oh, yeah.
And just getting a close-up view of the fire truck, you can just see.
I'm surprised they brought one that doesn't have the steerable rear wheels on it.
Yeah.
And next we've got VFW Post 4392, a veteran of foreign wars.
Also showing off the Fight the War Within Foundation.
Great group there.
And there we have the South Effingham High School Mustang Marching Band. Led by band director Sean McBride.
These youngsters make it look easy, but that's not the easiest thing to do, to walk and play an instrument.
No. Not at all. There we got the South Effingham
Junior ROTC.
Junior ROTC Mustangs.
Led by Lieutenant Colonel Terry Stoutberg. Hope I didn't mess his name up. Junior ROTC is just such a wonderful program. teaches these youngsters about discipline.
And as you said earlier, even if they don't take up a military career, it gives them some background,
gives
some service.
Them, gives them tools for life.
Well, look at this.
This would be...
something you'd see out of the scene from the TV show MASH.
Yeah.
Where's Mike?
That looks like a wonderful restoration.
And off in the distance, we do see the Effingham County High School Air Force Junior ROTC, home of the Rebel Airmen.
And behind their color guard, we have a wonderful example there, carrying the flag all spread out.
A large display. I wish we had our drone right now to,
yeah,
to show this off.
Shot. That would be wonderful. I believe that size of flag is known as a garrison flag, usually flown on a rather tall flagpole out in front of the post headquarters.
I was gonna say that one very, very tall flagpole.
Yeah.
You see people getting pictures of that from above.
That'd be the best vantage, that's for sure. Be the Marine Corps League color guard.
And also seeing some of the Marine Corps Jeeps.
Yep.
D Company, 5th Rifle Company.
Dog Company. Well, you know what they say, once a Marine, always a Marine.
Always.
I know Jimmy Ray would probably slap me if I didn't say that. The Iwo Jima silhouette coming by the reviewing stand.
That's a vantage point, too, having a nice little convertible.
Yeah.
Driving in this nice weather. Now,
beautiful, beautiful
we were worried about
it.
Rain, but looking up into the sky, not a cloud in the sky.
Sun's almost trying to get a little hot on us.
Mm-hmm.
Just a wonderful day for a parade.
And it is amazing how everything has cooperated here for the Veterans Day Parade. As we take a look at the Marine Corps League, seeing a Higgins boat right now. And I tell you what, we're going to take a quick break, and we're going to be back with more of the Savannah Veterans Day Parade coming up. Yeah. doing fabulous.
Trying.
Welcome back, everybody. We are taking a live look, checking out Oglethorpe Avenue now right now, and we are seeing people lined up on the parade route as we are bringing you the 2021 Savannah Veterans Day Parade. We are located on Oglethorpe and Abercorn, where we have been presenting this. We are right by the reviewing stand, as well as we are seeing these parade units coming through in Savannah and seeing a lot of sunshine as well, so that is good news.
And here we have a past Veteran of the Year, Jerry Walker from 2003. Lucky enough that we have a lot of the past veterans still with us.
Part of the Doberman
Doberman's
War Dogs group.
Dogs. Or, yep, War Dogs. And here we have Christy Krill with the Dive Savannah. The Dive Savannah is a restaurant that they do mostly catering. They don't have a storefront, but they all of their proceeds and all of their leftover food, it all gets boxed up and taken to homeless veterans and distributed throughout the community. And she's just doing a lot of great work for that.
It's an amazing service that you don't really
definitely
get to spotlight as much, so we're glad that we're able to bring that up here, and hopefully you can help out some of these organizations,
be a
part of the community.
Yep.
And of course we're seeing the Lions Club of Savannah, and of course the Lion Club, such a great organization, helping to get children glasses, something as necessary as that, making sure that they have the gift of sight. So they do a lot. Hey,
One of our past veterans that we lost this last year, Ed Wexler, was very big into that. He was an optometrist by trade. So lost a number of tremendous people this year. You know, some World War II vets and some other people, but
we're losing, especially World War II veterans. We're losing them.
Unfortunately,
more
yes.
and more. I recently had a chance to talk to a 97-year-old World War II veteran just last week, actually. And we're airing a story tonight on him, and he was part of a bombardier. He was a bombardier with the Mighty 8th Air Force, so that should be exciting. You want to watch it on WTOC tonight. Now we have the Jenkins High School Band.
Jenkins High Warriors.
Great job, Jenkins
Very nice.
High School Band.
1, 2!
Let's go!
Coming up behind the band and the flag team there, we've got the Jenkins Naval Junior ROTC cadets.
Got a little bit of distance there between the band.
A little bit of separation.
You always see that pride, especially here in front of the reviewing stand, when they snap off those salutes in front of.
They seem to walk a little bit straighter.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. All right, here we have the U.S. Coast Guard. And they don't get enough credit for all that they do here along our coast and all the search and rescues that they have to perform and just making sure people are doing their due diligence when they're out on the water.
And not to mention that the Coast Guard serves overseas, too. A lot of things that they do that people just really don't know about.
They don't understand.
And then coming up, we got a unit that's near and dear to my heart, American Legion Post 135. They're on Bull Street. We've got their American Legion Riders coming through right now, led by Jay Beasley, their director. And then the post itself, led by Sam Curry. Sam's also been very instrumental in that B-17 rebuild out there at the Mighty 8th Air Force Museum.
And again, if you haven't been out to the Mighty 8th Air Force Museum, make it a part of your trip. It's almost one of those should be a trip for all school-age children to be able to go out there and have a field trip.
Yep, you just can't miss that stuff.
Everybody's cheering for you, Mike. See, this is a little bit of what we get with Jimmy Ray here.
Yeah, but everybody knows Jimmy Ray. So. Thank you, Sam.
See ya.
And behind the walking members, we have the trolley that we have for some of our less mobile members. I can't be Jimmy Ray. I don't have that good of hair.
And we also have the McIntosh County Academy Marching Buccaneers out of Darien.
Making the trip up this morning, we really appreciate them. All these bands that come from outside the local Savannah area, it's just wonderful to see them.
And there we have the Chatham Artillery of Savannah, Georgia, organized May 1st, 1786.
Second oldest artillery unit in the United States. And they also built the buildings that Post 135 now occupies there on Bull Street.
Wow.
Those were completed in 1914. So, been around for a little while.
And there we have Sons of the American Revolution. Edward Telfair chapter. And And this float that we see here is the Urban Christian Academy.
So good to see young people coming out for this.
It's a beautiful float.
That it is. And a little bit behind them is the Savannah High School marching band.
And as they get closer, we're definitely going to hear from them. Everybody's getting their phones out as well. Take a little video and some pictures of it.
Yep.
Got the Blue Jackets.
And then we've
got was your Savannah High School band, and we have the Savannah High School Junior ROTC.
Led by Major Lucas Crabtree. Got a Humvee coming down the road from R&R Home Improvement.
Do a little bit of everything there for your home improvement. Little remodeling, interior, exterior. But I always love seeing those old vehicles coming through. There we have La Paterna Radio 96.1. La Pantera, excuse me. Decked out car right there, yeah. Veteran Carriers.
Veteran Carriers.
Someone likes to play with that bell off there on the trolley. Says Private Charter right there, the Special Force Green Berets. Check that out, and then they have all their names up there right underneath them as well.
They really don't get to toot their own horn while they're in, so I guess they like to ring that bell. Behind them, we've got the Groves High School marching band.
And as they get set up into place, we're going to get ready to listen to them. Part of the Rebel Band out of Garden City.
Hey! Oh!
right. Groves High School Rebel Band.
Followed closely by their junior ROTC, led by Lieutenant Colonel David London.
The Mighty Groves High School Rebels with their Army Junior ROTC, honoring all who served on this Veterans Day. Might be the largest contingency of Junior ROTC we've seen so far.
Pretty good size. It's great to see. Little bit of confusion in the ranks.
Groves High School ROTC. I think that car says it all. Thank you, veterans from the city of Pooler.
Yes, sir.
Seeing part of Pooler, the Pooler Mayor.
Yep, Pooler Mayor Rebecca Benton.
And the City Council. Hey.
Coming up next, we got Pooler Fire and Rescue.
Why do I just know that they're going to hit that alarm when they come right by us?
I would.
Hey there. And coming up in this trolley, we have part of the Pooler Senior Center.
Yeah. Wonderful to see their support.
There. waving the flags and showing off the red, white, and blue. Now we have the Islands High School Marching Band. Get ready to hear from the Sharks.
Love hearing that service medley.
The Islands High School Band doing a wonderful job, and yeah, you can tell when each branch of the service is played out and each veteran or of their selective military branch, and they stand with pride and beam at each time. And there we're seeing part of the WTOC Storm Chaser, Mariah Congito. We got Cyria Sandlin, Jake Wallace there as well.
Followed closely by the American Legion Post 500. And their commander this year is Mr. James Putney.
And again, you said that was the American Legion Post 500. All right, we're going to take a quick break, and we're going to be right back with more of your Savannah Veterans Day Parade. Stay with us. Okay. And based on this, we got about half a parade left.
It's getting warm.
Yeah, I know. There, how you doing?
Thank you.
And welcome back. We are taking a live look, checking out the Savannah Veterans Day Parade. Some of the littlest ones out there waving to our military veterans as they make their way through downtown Savannah on this lovely November day. Good to have you with us, everybody. I'm Mike Seelan. We've been bringing you this live coverage, joined by veteran Mike Ball. And Mike, just a lovely parade to be back in Savannah.
Just, and couldn't ask for a better day. Just gorgeous out here. Love to see all these young people out here with the bands and the ROTC units. It's amazing to, you know, see that there, you know, are still kids coming up that you know are holding these values, you know, true as we do,
and taking pride in all that they do.
Yep.
And right now, right in front of us, we do have the Richland Hardyville High School Band. Let's take a listen to them.
And, you know, I do want to correct myself just a little bit earlier before we went to break. There, we had the American Legion Post 500, and it's not James Putney is not their commander. He was their commander last year. It's Eddie Patterson this year. So just wanted to make that correction.
Making sure we get credit where credit is due. All right. Hospice Savannah honoring our veterans here in today's parade. Along with some fine four-legged friends.
They do such a wonderful job when that
time
end of life comes.
It's hard to talk about it, but glad that they are there to be able to help out.
Definitely.
During that very difficult time for a lot of families. Here we have the Savannah Regional Central Labor Council.
Great to see some of these businesses, and we got the IBEW coming up here, the different, you know, some of the unions that are such big supporters of Veterans Day and our veteran community.
Well, it says it all right there. We support our troops. International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers. And this is the part of the parade where sometimes our list of who's coming to the parade kind of gets out of order, so we're trying to
a little bit jumbled up.
To look through to make sure we find out and give the proper respect to the people that are coming through the parade.
Looks like we got John Parker. Is that John Parker? Yeah, John Parker, former Veteran of the Year. And here we've got a Jeep from Step One Automotive. They do a wonderful...
And people
lunch.
Go around and they sign that for breast cancer awareness, sign that vehicle. I actually put my name on there as well.
As did I. They do a lot for our veterans, though, too.
They'll just use that and put it on a check and have us sign
probably.
It, right?
Yeah, probably. Step One Automotive does a grab-and-go lunch about once a month at one of their dealerships where all veterans, active duty military, and first responders are welcome to come, and just they have a food truck there, and you can get you a lunch for free.
It's just great, the community service some of the unsung stuff that our local businesses are doing, trying to help out those that might be in need, or just to give them a little break from their tedium.
Yep. And last year they also, when we did the parade out in Port Wentworth, they provided, I think we had four food trucks out there to serve everyone after the parade was over. So that was a wonderful thing.
Part of the Grand Lake Club. Nice little Jeep/truck. And here we have the Johnson High School Band, the Atom Smashers. Mm-hmm.
coming
that
up
That was
now.
The Atom Smashers Johnson High School Band, and now Disabled American Veteran Chapter number 8 off of Tybee Island. You guys got the hot seat right there. You got the sunshine. What now?
Yeah, coming up, we've got Tammy Stokes here, candidate for Superior Court Judge.
Tammy Stokes. American Legion Post. Out of West Chatham.
Oh.
American Legion Post 322.
Happy Veterans Day!
Saluting Korean veterans and World War II veterans as well. Hey guys.
Man, I lost count.
Always great to see these guys. Get to see them in the monthly council meetings, but need to see them outside of that.
There we have part of the Chatham EMS, the emergency crew. First responders who are there on the scene when you definitely need them. Chatham Fire as well.
You know, Mike, it's like we say in the Army, no plan ever survives first contact, so.
Nope.
Kind of got to wait till we see what we got coming.
Yeah, we're looking at our list, and there we see the Rock of Savannah, I-95. And speaking of people that have just passed, we had Don Scott, longtime voice.
Yeah, definitely. And Kix 96.
And E93, Savannah's hip-hop and R&B leader.
Yeah. Be the new Hampstead High School marching band. Out there in Bloomingdale. Coming up behind them, we've got the New Hampstead Junior ROTC. Looks like an Air Force unit.
They also have a large contingent with them.
Again, we got a little bit of confusion in the ranks, but that's okay.
It's all well-intentioned.
Yes, it is. And the New Hampstead Junior ROTC, led by Major Kevin Oxendine.
Hookie! Hookie! Destroy!
We can destroy.
Hoorah! Hoorah the city!
We rock the city!
Now leave it!
Way back!
Now leave it!
Way back!
Now stop! And beat your face, cause this fight for the right this place. Aru! Ha ha! Aru! VX!
Who are you motivated?
Yes, sir!
Are you motivated?
Yes, sir!
How motivated are you?
And coming up behind the New Hampstead High School ROTC, Junior ROTC, we have the American Heritage Girls Troop.
Go boy!
Of course, Girl Scouts, obviously, starting right here in Savannah back in 1912.
So much history in this town. Followed by the American Red Cross here.
Disaster relief, they have been a workout not only here locally whenever there's a disaster. They are the first on the scene trying to help out families, but we've seen with other natural disasters around the country, they go here from the Savannah area to places like Louisiana and Texas and South Carolina.
Yep.
and all over the place wherever they can be of service.
Just amazing work. And behind them, we got the guys that fall out of planes. The 82nd Airborne Division Association. This year they are led by none other than Mr. Doug Andrews.
I love how you put that. They fall out of planes.
They get paid
I don't know
to
if they
do
put it,
it
that way.
They get paid to do it. So I always got paid to stay in them. So I just
You're good. You're good, right? No, it's flying, right? It's good.
God bless them. It takes
these,
all of them.
I was going to say, but these are the men that go into some of the worst areas
yes,
you can
do.
Imagine
yep.
and are dropped in. And there we're seeing a little bit coming up into our vantage point. We have the Windsor Forest High School Band, the Marching Knights here in Savannah. Of course, they have part of their dance team leading the band.
Dance team, flag team, they got it all. So I think I hear the band off in the distance.
Making its way, getting their position. Band director Stephen Johnson getting the band in sight to turn in front of the reviewing stand.
We'll be right back.
Windsor Forest High School Band.
Motorcycles here. We've got Strike Team for Vets. These are guys that and gals that, when there's a veteran in distress, they answer the call and they go head straight over to their house and try and talk them on off a ledge. Do a lot of good work trying to prevent veteran suicide in this.
I was gonna say that's an organization much needed. Just to help. To let other veterans know
that
they're not alone with what they're going through and that there are people you can reach out to try to get some help.
Yeah, and unfortunately, there's too much work for them
right now.
The big number that's out there is 22 a day, but it's actually more like 30 veterans a day that commit suicide. And so it's something that we're all trying to address and we're all trying to lesson, and I mean one a day is too many, so we're all working for that end.
Here we have the Windsor Forest High School Junior ROTC.
Junior Army ROTC.
All of these, you know, high schoolers have been in line since before 9 a.m. today to just get to this point in the parade. So I want to thank them for their dedication to the Veterans Day Parade as well. And there, we're hearing a little rumble out here, loud rumble.
VFW Post 660 and their VFW riders.
Just a great day to be out on a bike like that. Especially seeing some of the little kids out there. They are enjoying this so much.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to see if I still got my hearing. It's a lot louder, the sounds of those motorcycles here, than possibly than what you're getting at home. But
when you can feel it
very
in your
loud
chest.
And very impressive.
Kind of makes you wonder what Rolling Thunder up in D.C. would be like with thousands of them. Got the trolley from Post 660.
Navy! Army strong! Always a veteran! Air Force! Air Force! Always a veteran! Army strong! Always a veteran! Air Force! The men are strong!
Yeah, nobody ever fights about what service they serve, right? Or what branch they were in.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of sibling rivalry in the services.
Just but, a little, huh?
You know, it's when it comes down to the end of the day, we're all about the same thing, and that's making it better for our fellow veterans.
Making a better
and
country
our communities.
Team Savannah for Veterans, helping veterans any way you can.
These guys get out there and put hands on local projects for veterans that are in need, and they do a lot of great work.
Oh, and look at these little guys, part of the Cub Scouts and Boy Scouts, Pack 7.
Great to see scouting still alive and doing well, and kids getting a sense of accomplishment.
And thriving, yeah, just marking off those badges get and moving up ranks.
Yep. Follow-up truck here for Boy Scout Troop 7.
Just a very simple thank you, veterans. And that conveys so much and so little at the same time. You can't even put into words what you want to thank these veterans for all that they've done.
And here we've got the Savannah Elks Lodge, led this year by Ed Gazzara. And they are very, very veteran friendly. They're not a veterans organization per se, but they do a lot for veterans. Coming up, we've got Howmet Aerospace, and they do a tremendous amount for veterans too. So it's great to see them.
Here we got St. Leo University, one of the fine universities here in the Savannah area.
A lot of veterans avail themselves of St. Leo's classes and get their degrees after, during, or after their service.
Honoring all those who serve from Alfred Ely Beach High School, celebrating and honoring Veterans Day.
At the Beach High Junior ROTC.
That very loud,
yeah,
big old vehicle
bus from Yates Astro.
You got termite or pest problems,
trying to
call.
Keep the pests out of your life.
In the Beach High School ROTC. And Yates Astro displaying each branch of the military with their flags. Get ready for them. We're going to have quite a few coming through here with the Ailey Temple Shriners.
I just wish they'd have brought all their little go-karts out.
Well, we can't see that far. They might have some back
there.
We don't know.
There. Oh, yeah. That's true. Quite a contingent out here.
When the Shriners come out to a parade, Shriners come out to a parade.
They come out in force.
A lot of units into this parade. But, of course, the Shriners do so much throughout the year, especially with the Shriner Children's Hospital helping out sick children and helping out their families as well.
Yep, definitely.
Yep, you were mentioning the go-karts. I see.
Oh, there they are.
I see some back there.
Good deal. It's just not a parade without the go-karts.
and just what we were talking about, Shriners helping children. And that's what it's all about. They have a lot of fun in what they do, but it's all for a serious cause. And
that's true.
That's the best way to do it.
Yep.
Maybe not as many Dune cats this year, but we got a few.
Yep. Got a couple coming. And then they're big plus. The big old
pirate ship. Of
course,
we got the big old pirate ship coming through.
Classic Toby Keith on the speakers there.
I was waiting for the big cannon boom on
yeah.
that one.
Got their bus coming down.
The Effingham Shrine Club. There, how you doing? What's going on? Good to see you. Home of the Effingham River Rats.
Yeah, there we go.
And the Hillbillies coming through. Of course, you can't leave home without the outhouse.
No, no. Hey, that thing comes in handy in a long parade.
I was going to say, right? Part of the Hinesville Shrine Club. Hillbilly Jack.
Hinesville Hillbillies.
Got a little Garfield on the side.
Yep.
Part of the Hinesville Fort Stewart Shrine Club. Now, what do we got here? Whoa! Hold on now. Hold on.
Looks like some drifters.
Whoa! Woo! Watch out for our cameras now.
Guess they got bored with the conventional little buggies.
It's like there's sandpaper on those back wheels. Maybe there's
something. And the Brunswick Shrine.
Scrubbing the streets. All right. Yeah, part of the Brunswick Shrine Club making their way up. Thank you for coming up to Savannah for this. No man stands so tall as when he stoops to help a child.
A lot of truth in that statement.
Yeah, I always love this float whenever you see it in the parade, any parade.
Yep.
Can't get much better than hear a little bit of Rolling Stones as well.
Yeah, and with the Statue of Liberty there with the flame coming up, that's just awesome.
On the front it says, "Welcome home Gulf War veterans." On the side, "Welcome home Vietnam veterans." I want to thank all of our veterans for serving in any
war or conflict. And here, I believe, this might be the Wheeler County High School Band. Taking home some hardware, it looks like, apparently, as well.
Looks to be.
Smile for the camera.
And after the Wheeler High School Band, we have the Veterans Day Parade adjutant staff led by Mike Brady. Always doing
and Mike
the
does a lot of
work.
Does so much. He
yes,
always
he
helps
does.
Us out, helping to bring this parade as well. I hear you. Right? The end. And there we have the end of the Savannah Veterans Day Parade, and just a great day, a great parade, great weather here for everything that happened in mm-hmm. Savannah. Mike, what did you think?
It was just a tremendous experience, and I just very honored to be up here. And I want to thank everybody that came out today, everybody that was watching on TV, just a wonderful parade, and it's such an honor to serve.
Well, we appreciate you. Thank you for your service. Thank you to all of our veterans out there. We want to thank you for taking the time to come to us and allow us into your homes to bring you this very special day in Savannah. Again, I'm Mike Cielo with Mike Ball from the Savannah Veterans Day Parade. Thank a veteran, and thank you all for your service.